Every square foot of land is designed and developed to live sustainably, to maximize resources.
So instead of taking space to grow crops, now we're harvesting solar energy.
Sure, we could have systems that were custom, well, very expensive and custom jobs, so that's not really a homestead attitude.
One of the new features of our solar homestead is a modern trommel. We use the thermal leverage, if you will, of phase change materials. They melt at a constant temperature, so as long as you have phase change materials melting, you don't overheat. We melt at about 27 to 29 degrees C. As the sun comes in, you melt the phase change materials. Stays warm, but not too warm. And we don't have to have as much thermal mass. The phase change materials leverage, because they're changing phases, you have lots of thermal mass available. As you get afternoon sun, the wall will warm up, and then when it cools down at night and you need the heat, they will re-radiate the heat back into the space.
Our photovoltaic power system is incredibly dynamic. One aspect being the fact that we are a completely zero energy home with an 8.2 kilowatt system. We are integrating bifacial solar panels.
The panels that we decided to go with on our house can collect solar radiation from both sides. Obviously, this is a nice performance boost. It did lead to some interesting design scenarios where you had to account for that extra boost and prepare your system for higher than normal currents and voltages, but overall, it's a perfect match.
Another innovation in the solar homestead is the integration of two technologies, a skylight and solar thermal collection, so we call it the solar thermal skylight.
We decided to go with concentrators to cut costs, basically, as well as reach the high temperatures, which is very critical for the latent energy storage the phase change material needs.
We spend a lot of time picking out energy efficient appliances. They're all Energy Star, of course.
The rest of the team quickly pointed out that it also had to look good.
We didn't want to be extravagant, but we also weren't afraid to spend money because it's important and that will pay back. Our house is very tight. It has controlled air infiltration, and it also has a very robust thermal envelope. We reach R40 on all surfaces, walls, ceilings, and floors. And we also have R5 windows. We don't need large HVAC systems.
We decided to use the range hood as a whole house fan so we could activate that if we needed to draw fresh air into the house. We have separate passive fresh air openings as well as some active ones.
Most hot water heaters, as you've seen them, they're big tanks full of water, and you have an electric element for backup, and then you have a solar loop putting solar heat into it. We have no water. We don't store the energy in water. We store the energy in phase change materials. So we use a paraffin phase change material, and we pack the heat into that, and we can store nearly the same amount of heat as you can with a 200-gallon water tank.
We're trying to build a reputation for the solar industry of providing quality products at a good price that are going to work the way they say they're going to work.
We're doing it much like nature would do as well with the bifacial panels.
These bifacial panels that offer a translucent effect really brings about this sense of connection, if you will, that you can go out on the great porch and experience renewable energy in a way that you couldn't if it were just tacked on your roof.